This is Pat Salver with the Dr. Weighs In, and I'm filming today at a meeting on the Stanford campus, the beautiful Stanford campus, and the meeting is put on by Health Excel, which is a Beyond Accelerator out of Dublin. And I have with me today Rick Altinger, who is with, here's another cool name in healthcare, guys, Glooko, G-L-O-O-K-O. So, Rick, thanks, what Kat. Is Glooko?
Well, first, thanks for being here. It's very exciting. I actually took a thermodynamics class in 1984 up in that classroom right there.
So you're an engineer.
So I'm an engineer by training, went here and have both the bachelor's and master's from here, and it's exciting to be here. So Glooko is a product and service for managing populations with diabetes. It's a pandemic. It's costing a lot of money for our health system, and it's a burden for people with diabetes to manage this disease. And so it's a combination of a mobile hardware solution where we liberate data from the blood glucose meters that are used by tens of millions of people today, because people aren't changing their meters.
Whatever meter they have, you can liberate it?
We have 30-plus meters that we support, and it's a Bluetooth device that can speak all the different data protocols and electrical protocols is the wizardry.
You reverse engineered all of these glucometers?
No, we worked over the course of years with their specs. So we went out to each of the companies. And the original founders of Glooko are also from Stanford University. They are actually the same people that developed the Ethernet standard back in the 70s. So figured all that out and said, yeah, there is a low-cost hardware device, so you connect this to your blood glucose meter, and it then communicates, our latest version communicates via Bluetooth to any of your mobile phones, whether it's a iPhone or a Samsung Android device. I see one of my board members actually upstairs, Andy Atwell from Samsung. They're an investor in Glooko. And so it puts the data in this app.
Is the data just the glucose level, or is it other data?
It's other data as well. So the data that comes out of the glucose meter is the blood glucose and date and time. That's the cornerstone to managing your diabetes. But then you can add whether you're fasting or not. There's a full food database in there, so you can get educated as to how many carbs are in that Subway meatball sandwich, for example. Because that sandwich, they'll tell you how many calories are in it, but they don't tell you how many carbs are in it. And that's what's key for someone with diabetes. And then it also reminds you when to take your medication, when to test, and you can log all of that. Equally, if not more important, puts that data in the cloud so that your care provider team can access it and coach you and help you.
So I trained many years ago in endocrinology, actually right when we first started measuring blood glucoses, and people used to come in, do you remember those old blue books that we took tests in? And they would come in and they would have, like 75 glucose measurements, and I could never do anything with it because I couldn't contextualize it. Are you actually going to contextualize it so when the doctor looks at it, it says, this is after this dose of insulin, after this meal, and after this exercise?
Do you want to be a spokesperson for Glooko? Yes. So it does that today. So it contextualizes, and it, for example, allows you to see a graph by time of day where you look at over the last 3 months, all their readings by hour. And when they took their insulin or didn't take their insulin, and all that contextual information is there for you in individual reports for your patients. And equally important then, there's also a population view where you can take a look at and say, okay, here is my list of patients. Show me all the patients that have had a significant hypo event in the last week of below 60, for example. And then those are the patients where you have to intervene. And that becomes the coachable moment, right? So if you remember, very few people actually did that paper log, and very few people did today.
But when they did it, it was really a drag to have them hand it to you and think you were going to do something with it.
Even if they did it, it was hard for you to deal with it, right?
I didn't deal with it.
You need to take a look at our reports. Endocrinologists love them. So, for example, Dr. Howard Wolpert at the Joslin Center is one of our customers, loves the product. Dr. Mark Clements from Mercy Children's in Kansas City loves the views that we have. And then you have the opportunity, or the nurse educator, the diabetes educator in essence, has the opportunity, say it's Tuesday morning and they see a patient last night on a Monday night had a severe hypo at 55. that becomes the opportunity to intervene. And instead of waiting for them to come in and you fishing through the paper log and saying, oh, 3 months ago, I see on a Monday night you had a hypo reading, now it's timely. You can say, call the patient or message the patient on the platform and say, what was going on last night? You have a big opportunity to teach and have an impact at that point.
Well, the product sounds really cool, and I'm looking forward to taking a look at it online and also when we're together in Scottsdale for an upcoming conference. I want to close by asking you quickly just a little bit about Health Excel. What motivated you to apply to attend this, and has this worked out for you? Has this been a worthwhile experience for you?
Yeah, it's been great. So Health Excel brings together leaders in the healthcare community like Cleveland Clinic or others, IBM and such, with their big employee base, and they are basically looking for innovations to bring to their constituents and such. So I think they filtered a couple hundred different companies down to a handful or two. So we were honored to be able to present, and now those entities are seriously looking. Since we made the qualifications, we've now presented to them, and they are seriously looking to implement our system. I don't have them signed on the dotted line yet, but the access to them has been wonderful, and it's a real honor to be to make the final cut, in essence, as a leader. We're a little further along as a company. We've gotten FDA clearance. We're HIPAA compliant. We have about 22 employees, so we're not an early accelerator type entity. We are really, in prime time. We have thousands of people using the product.
Well, it's been wonderful talking to you, and I want to congratulate you not only on making it to Health Excel, but for developing a product that will be so helpful for diabetics everywhere. Thank you very much, Rick.
Thanks for having us.